10-meter car.
Yep.
Here you go. Ta-da!
Lovelies, welcome back to another cheeky little Monky London car review. We're doing a German special today. First time driving a M50 turbo as well. This is Lars's car. Lars actually built this car by himself at home, and he's quite a keen drifter. Does sound quite sort of 2J. I mean, it's six cylinder, it's got a turbo, and yeah, it does have that sort of Jay-Z reminiscent sound, which is pretty neat. It's about 35 degrees and Lars and I are literally dripping in this car. You got aircon?
No.
Stupid question. Oh mate, this is not slow, is it? This is the quickest E36 I've been in. This is rapid! I like the colour, man. Lars thinks it's a cheap colour, but I think it's a cool colour. I really like it. It's a 10 metre car.
Yep.
Here you go. Ta-da! Looks fresh. M3 mirrors as well. Genuine.
Cool.
Scum. And that was the banded steels that we were talking about. Now I look, they're a little bit different to contours, but I think they look quite nice with the deep little dish. Is that an M3?
M3.
Ah, sick, man. It's got the little extended lip on the bottom. Yeah, I do like the E36 M3 stuff. And that's kind of what I was saying with the bodywork as well. If you look down the side, it's not overly wide, this car, but it's just got a little bit of poke. I do think it looks pretty cool in this geese. That's his exhaust system. It's got a little downturn on it as well, which is what quite a lot of drifters do just to try and reduce noise, because the sound kind of resonates down first and off the ground, and that kills some of the sound. So that's why you quite often see downturned exhausts on skid cars.
Drift, baby.
Spoilerless, and he's just got a little roof mounted spoiler on the top. Nice and simple, to be honest. It's what I would consider a nice looking E36 skid car and a usable drift car on the road as well.
Send it.
Sparco sprint bucket seats, some sort of harnesses, not sure on the steering wheel, possibly a Nardi. It looks to be Nardi, bit of JDM goodness. That's your hydro handbrake with the Willwood master cylinder.
and that's obviously your shifter. Here he's just got a little plate with a battery kill switch, which is quite important on a skid car. And then here you've got the electric fan controller for the radiator, and that's for his oil cooler.
Germany looking absolutely beautiful today. 100% standard.
All right, let's jump back in the car. We've got some water now so we can actually stay alive. That's the other thing with these kind of cars as well. When you start running bigger engines, turbos, bigger gearboxes and start stripping them out, you do start to feel the heat. But that's one of the things with skid cars, is the most important thing really is you've got to try and keep not only you cool inside, but keeping the engine cool is an absolute fundamental. Whereas regular race cars are going around a track, they're kind of, they're on wide open throttle, but they're not hammering it off the limiter. Whereas a drift car, because you're working the clutch and stuff, yeah, a lot and banging it off the limiter, it gets a lot hotter.
You don't get so much air to the coolers.
Yeah, very good point. And that's why a lot of the time you see rear mounted radiators. And that's because when the guys are sideways, they can still pull air into the rad. Right, let's drive before we start passing out with heat exhaustion.
What power is it running now, Lars? You've had it maxed. What boost and what power?
Around 1 bar and around 370 horsepower.
370 at 1 bar. It's quite a lot. And what turbo is that on?
GTX 3071.
GTX 3071. Okay, so it's quite. It's not a small turbo. It's not massive, but
not massive, but not a small turbo.
Yes. Yeah. We've got a little bit of a straight, so we'll open her up and show you guys what she's all about. Okay, so it's probably about 320 brake per ton. It's quite a lot, isn't it? It's a good power to weight ratio. M50 is a better option for boosting in the long run. It's a stronger engine.
Yes, you get more parts for the M50. You can basically stick the same parts on the M52, but the aluminium block with the random engine before with stock compression, stock pistons and what. It's around the same power level, but with a bigger, leggier turbo. It was okay, but the pistons always broke on me, so the ring lamps broke.
Ah, I got you. Yep. Started getting ring lamp failure.
Yes, and okay. It was so annoying that I go forged.
Relatively speaking, as long as the map's good and the cooling's decent, it's quite a bulletproof engine, it's quite a strong,
yes,
reliable engine.
But for that kind of power, yeah.
What about things like the gearbox? Is it stock 325 gearbox?
No, they come with a get track, and this is a ZF.
ZF box. Yeah, okay. And then what about the diff?
That's a stock 325 one. It's welded. One. I have another one with shorter gear ratio, but this one drives better.
Okay. I guess you can, if you do like a very small circuit, you can swap out to the other diff if you need to.
Yeah.
What about the arms and the bushes and stuff? Adjustable camber arms and stuff?
Yes, adjustable camber arms on the rear and all around poly bushes from Strong Flex.
Yep. Jamie K, baby.
Thank you.
brakes on this, you were saying they're stock 325 brakes.
Yep.
What about the lock kit? Because you've got quite a lot of lock in this. I'm guessing you've got cut knuckles, welded knuckles.
Yes. Cut and welded knuckles and extended lock
arms. How much?
How much extent? 30 millimeters.
30 mil, I'd say. So pushes it out quite a bit.
Yes.
Then I guess you've got aftermarket front wings to allow for the wider wheels.
Yep. They're from some Polish guy, Stolarworks, I think. I bought the whole kit for them.
And the rear quarters as well.
Curious.
I think they look quite nice. I think there's a certain way you can kind of style an E36 to make it look kind of quite sort of classy.
Yep.
And I think this is one of those kits. It's not sort of over the top. It doesn't look like a hovercraft, but it just gives it a nice, slightly wider look, doesn't it?
Wider look, but the lines are still like the OEM ones.
Yeah, it does look really cool, this. And the colour you were saying, this, I quite like this colour. It's like a sort of navy dark blue. But you were saying this colour's from like a 316?
Yes.
Is it only?
I think it's only on the 316 and 318. So it's a cheap colour.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I guess this had a 316 motor in it to start with?
Yes.
Okay.
It's a 316 shell. So I bought a whole 316 and swapped everything over.
Roll cage as well, painted it in IKEA Formula Gold. We like in the gold, man. And the cage, is it bolted or welded?
All welded.
It's welded in?
Yes.
Nice, man. And you've got some good, nice gusseting down the A-pillar as well.
Yep.
And then what about the wheels on this? They're quite interesting. Are they banded?
Yeah, banded steelies from Opel Insignia.
Ah, it's from an Insignia.
Yeah.
They look cool, though. They almost look reminiscent of the contours. You know, the BMW M3 Saloon had those contours?
Yeah.
I don't know if you remember the wheel. They're almost a little bit similar in looks to that.
Yep.
And they're probably quite cheap for you to make, aren't they, the banded steels?
Yeah, you can buy those steelies in their raw form for, if you're lucky, for 50 euros
a
set. And then you have to spend some time cutting and welding
them. Splitting and welding them, yeah. They do end results, though, they look really cool.
Yeah.
And they're not like overly expensive wheels. They look great, but if you damage them, it's not the end of the world.
Yeah, exactly.